Hello students, after completing chapter 2, today I will start chapter 3, okay? Your chapter 3 is working with tables. Now the first question is, what is table? A table is a grid of cells arranged in horizontal rows and vertical columns. Okay, we can use a table to present textual and numerical data. Textual means alphabets, numerical means 1, 2, 3, okay? In a concise way, means in a brief way, okay? We can even insert picture in the cells to lend visual appeal to data. That means you can explain better with the help of picture if you will insert in the tables, okay? Now understand the constructions of table, okay? Open it, click on the start button. Now click on the MS of Microsoft Office Word, okay? Now click on the insert option, choose table and insert few rows and columns. You can see here three rows. This one is called rows. Rows 1, rows 2 and rows 3. That is called column. Column 1, column 2 and column 3. Okay. So here this combination is called grid of cells. This particular box is called cell. Okay, this particular box is called cell. So you can say a table is a combination of rows and columns or grid of cells. Got it? Understand? Now the next topic is inserting table using the table grid. So how to insert a table using the table grid, understand it. And okay, first you will click on the insert option, then click on the table option, and after that you will choose the option, this option. This option is called table grid option. Okay, look, one cell, two by two rows and two column, three rows and three column, four rows and four column, five rows and five column, six rows and six columns. How many rows and columns do you want? Just drag your mouse diagonally, okay, and after that click, then it will be insert. Okay, that is a process to insert a table using the table grid. Okay, now next topic, other methods of inserting a table. Okay, so one by one I will explain you other methods to insert a table, okay, in Microsoft Word. Second way, click on insert option, then click on the table option. Okay, after that choose insert table option, then it will ask how many rows and columns. Then I will write here 10 columns and 5 rows. Okay, now click on the OK button. You can see 10 rows and 5 columns has inserted. If you have any confusion, then first you will delete the previous tables, click on the layout option, choose delete option, delete tables. Okay, so first you will delete the previous table. After that you will insert a new table. Insert table, insert table option, choose number of rows and column. Okay, I have entered 10 columns and 5 rows and press okay. Then you can see 1 2 3 4 5 6 7 8 9 10 column and 5 rows has inserted. That is a second way to insert a table. Okay,
Now again delete this one. You can delete this one, select from here. When you click here, then whole table will select, then click on the layout option and then choose delete option, and after that choose delete table option, then it will delete. Now choose the second option, again click on insert, click on the table option, choose draw table option. After that you can draw. Okay, like that. How many rows, how many columns you want to make, you can draw. Okay, like that. Any confusion? So in this way you can create a tables. That is the third way to create a tables. Now select this one again. Okay, and choose layout option and choose delete table option. Now the next way, click on the tables again and choose quick table option. Okay, when you click a quick table option, then it will give you a predefined formats, a predefined formats to enter insert a table. So which format you will choose, that format will be insert. Okay, if you want to insert this type of which type of tables do you want to insert, just click on that one and that type of table will be insert, and after that you can edit the data. You can edit the data according to need and you can create your own tables in this way. That is called a quick method. Okay, clear? The last method to insert a table is, first select it. When this symbol appear, not this one, this plus symbol. Okay, then you will click here, then you will click on the layout option, and then after that you will delete. Okay, the last option to insert a table, click on insert, click on the table and choose Excel spreadsheet. Okay, then Excel spreadsheet will be insert. You know Excel spreadsheet is a combination of rows and columns only, so you can insert or Excel to make a tables, and you can enter the records in this Excel sheet in your Microsoft Office Word file. Okay, is that clear? So all methods I have explained to insert a table. Okay, now next topic, resizing and moving a table. Okay, resizing and moving a table. In this topic I will explain you how to resize and you will move the tables. Okay, got it? Now understand this one. First you will insert one table. I am going to use this option, table grid option, 6 by 6. 6 by 4. Okay, after that how to move a table with this symbol is called moving handle, so you can move your tables. This one is called moving handle, this one, this sign. Okay, then hold it and move your table. Okay, and this one is called resizing table handle. Through this one you can resize your tables. Look, got it? So that is a way to resize and moving a table. Okay, so once a table is inserted, you can change its size and position by using the dragging action of the mouse. Okay, so through this symbol you can move, and through this symbol you can resize the table. This one is called move handle and this one is called sizing handle. Okay, now next one is entering data in tables. That is very easy. Where you want to enter data, just click on that cell and write data. Okay, if you want to enter here, then write here and you can enter the data. Okay, so this is the way to enter our records or data in a tables. Just click on that cell. Okay, and after that you can edit the values. Got it? Now next one, if you are here and you want to go the first cell of the column, you are in a third cell of the column. If you want to go in first cell of the column, then you will use Alt and Page Up option. Okay, when you then you press Alt key and Page Up option. See, you will reach the first cell of the column. Again, when you click on the Alt key and page down, then you will reach the last cell of the column. Okay, when you press Alt and Home key, which key? Home. Look, then you will be reached a first cell of the row, and when you press Alt and End key, then you will reach the last cell of the row. Again, understand it. If you are here, when you press Alt Page Up, then you will go in a first cell in that column. Again, when you will press Alt plus Page Down, then you will go last cell of the column. Then you press Alt and Home, then you will go first cell of the row, and then you press Alt plus End, then you will go last cell of the row. So these are called short keys to move your mouse cursor from one cell to another cell. Okay, these are called short keys, keyboard short keys. Okay, that is used to move. Okay, so with the help of these keys you can move in a column, first cell of that column and last cell of that column, or first cell of that row or last cell of that row. Okay, so today homework is, you will do this activities given on page number 26. Okay, create a 5x7 means 5 columns and 7 rows. You know, the first one represent the number of columns and the second one rows represent the number of rows. 5x7 means 5 columns and 7 rows you will create in the tables in MS Word. Okay, and after that you will create this document, that is your homework. Okay, so next topic I will teach you in a next video. Have a good day.